I love you not because of who you are, but because of whom I am when I am with you. These lines have been imbibed in the story of the two characters which we are going to present before you today. Throughout generation, their story has been passed down as part of a legend. So I am Katha Vachak, and welcome to the realm of Katha. So let's begin. So this Katha starts from the city of Verona. There were two very influential families who used to live in the city of Verona. But both the families were at loggerheads with each other. Since generations to remember, these both families were in a tussle and all the members hated each other. One day, one of the families was having a great party to which several people were invited. Now, one young man from the second family decided to disguise himself and attend the party with one of his friends. As they were standing in a corner, they saw a lot of girls dancing. Soon, the young man's gaze fell upon one of the girls and he was mesmerized out of his wits. He started feeling really elated and felt the love of first sight. As he was telling about the girl to his friend, one of the cousins of the girl heard the whole conversation and he was angry like anything. He decided that he should teach a lesson to the boy and decided to take out his sword. But then he saw a lot of people around, and so he decided otherwise, and he thought, okay, I'll probably teach him a lesson at a later point of time. Once the party was over, the young man decided to hide and started listening on the girl's conversation with her friends. The girl was actually telling her friends about the same young man and was praising him a lot. She was telling her friends that she was starting to feel in love. As soon as the young man heard this, he immediately came out of his hiding place and presented his love before the girl. The girl was a little taken aback, but then when she saw the young man's eyes, she realized that he also was in love with her, and she proclaimed her love for him, and they both decided to take it forward. Now from that party, the young man went straight to one of his friends, Friar Lawrence. Now Friar Lawrence was a great friend for both the families, and he really wanted both the families to come together and be friends with each other, but he was not successful at doing that. As soon as he heard the boy's tale, he found an opportunity. He thought that if I could get both of these together, I think I can bring the families together as well. And so he decided to help the boy. A few days after this, the boy was traveling in a market with one of his friends, when suddenly the girl's cousin came in front of him. The cousin started abusing him left, right, center, and soon it broke out into an out and out war. Both started fighting with each other with their swords. Unfortunately, at one point, the boy struck the cousin and the cousin fell down and he died on the spot. When the girl heard about this, she really felt bad and sad about the whole incident. But then she thought there must be something wrong that the cousin had done, to which the boy reacted in such a way. Now, as the cousin was also from that influential family, the king of that kingdom punished the young boy and ordered him to leave the kingdom forever. The boy was really dejected. So he went to his friend Friar Lawrence and asked for advice. After hearing his whole story, Friar Lawrence advised him to leave the kingdom. But before doing that, he advised him to go and meet the girl. He also assured the boy that he would think of some way to get both of them back together. So the boy went straight to the girl from there. They both met as if they were meeting for the last time, and they both proclaimed their love to each other. They vowed to live and die together. And after that, the boy left. The day that the young man left the kingdom, the same day the girl's parents came to her and told her that they had found another match for her and had decided to get her married. The girl protested a lot, but they didn't listen and told her that within the week she would be married off to the other boy. Now the girl was a little dejected, so she went to Friar Lawrence for advice. When she told the whole story to him, Friar Lawrence said, "Okay, don't panic. What we'll do is I'll give you one medicine. This medicine will slow your heart rate down and people will think that you have died. But the medicine will be effective for only 42 hours. So once that time is over, me and the boy will come and we'll take you out of the coffin and then you can get married and live off. Girl thought that this was a good idea, so she took the medicine from Fair Lawrence and went back home. One day before she was supposed to be married, she ate that medicine and she fainted. Everyone thought that she had passed away and they were filled with grief. They laid her body down into a coffin and took her to a graveyard. Now, meanwhile, Freya Lawrence had sent this message through a messenger to the boy. But unfortunately, before the messenger could reach the boy, the news of the girl passing away reached the boy. He was flabbergasted. In his grief, he rushed to a shop and bought a vial of poison and rushed towards the graveyard. As soon as he reached there, he saw his beautiful beloved lying in a coffin dead. And he was dejected out of his wits. He took the vial out of his pocket and finished the bottle completely. And soon he passed away. After a few moments, the girl came to consciousness and she saw the boy lying there. She tried to wake him up but then realized that the boy had died. Realizing the whole situation, she vowed to herself that she would also kill herself for her beloved. She thought that there must be some poison left on the boy's lips. So she touched her lips to his, but could not find solace as there was a very little poison there. So then she took out a dagger and killed herself. When both the families learned about their deaths, they were really saddened. They decided to let go of their rivalry and decided to honor both the lovers by forging a new alliance amongst themselves. Both the lovers were laid to rest together. And a huge statue was built to honor their divine love. I'm sure by now you must have guessed who were these two people I was talking about throughout this story. The boy was no other than Romeo, and the girl was Juliet. The love story of Romeo and Juliet has been part of a legend. It has been passed down generation. Romeo and Juliet have been idol for budding lovers who swear by their love. So this was today's katha. We'll bring such interesting stories to you another time. Until then,